I talk about India, and I a couple of days ago in my Urdu stream, I spoke with an Indian Muslim. He came up with a new idea. He said, you know what? Islam is a religion of peace. But all the things that I talk about, and because I'm Pakistani, so I usually talk about what's happening from Pakistani perspective. All these mullahs, all these clerics jumping up and down, beating kids, and you know, doing all the nasty things that they do. So he came, and obviously he'd been watching me for a while. He said, so Harris, it's actually Pakistani Muslims. He threw Pakistan, his fellow Pakistani Muslims under the bus. He said, these Pakistani Muslims are the problem, not Islam. Because in India, we don't do any of that shit. That's what he said. I was like, really? Zakir Naik is your guy. And I'm just going to tell you, give you a brief history of just last 2 weeks. This guy, Wasim Rizvi, said that 26 verses should be removed. And then one of the clerics put 1.1 million rupees on his head. And he said, if he can't come up with the money, he will sell his own children. He's an Indian Muslim, the one who's openly inciting people to behead him, that one. And then after that, there's another, this mainstream Indian Muslim politician said that this Hindu pundit, he should, his head and tongue should be cut off. He's not some random Muslim guy, a politician, AAP party or something. Anyway, so it's a democratically elected politician saying that. They held marches, demonstrations, showing the beheaded corpses of Wasim Rizvi and this Hindu pundit that I'm about to show you as well. So I said, all of the, and this is just in the last 2 weeks. So what is he talking about? You know, he had an Indian nationalist in him, so he had to diss Pakistan. But he also had a Momin in him. So he said, well, how do I do that? Because in religion, Indian Muslims and Pakistani Muslims are brothers. But, you know, he had to throw him under the bus. So he did do it. So have a look at this video. Another genius came to surface in this video. I work very hard to put these subtitles on for you non-Urdu Hindi speakers. Because, you know, I think it's very important that you guys see it. So have a look at this guy. He says, this Islamic cleric in India again, so not Pakistani, you know, this crap exists everywhere in the world. And I do admit that I think Pakistan, this subcontinent Islam is probably has taken the worst form. Because they are the biggest lovers of the Prophet, and they proudly say that you should. The video I'm about to show you, he literally said that he's sick and tired of peacefully requesting the authorities to behead these blasphemers. He said he's sick and tired of it. he said, we request them to bring us his head, but they don't do it. So I'm sick and tired of this. So, they have gone absolutely nuts. So have a look at this.
Us maloon tak pahuncha de agar zara barabar bhi dam kham hai tumhare andar tumhari maa ne agar doodh pilaya hai tumko to ab main munazire ka challenge nahi de raha hu debate bhi nahi karunga baat cheet bhi nahi karunga aao main elan karta hu 8 din ke andar tum delhi pahuncho kisi maidan mein pahuncho अपनी सारी मुकद्दस किताबें लेकर के आओ इंशाअल्लाह अजीज ये फकीर कुरान पाक लेकर हाजिर होगा हम आएंगे तुम अपने सारे गुरु घंटालों को लेकर जमा हो जाओ मैं मुनाजरे का चैलेंज नहीं दे रहा हूँ तवज्जो चाहता हूँ मैं डिबेट करने की बात ही नहीं कर रहा हूँ ये न्यूज एंकर जितने दज्जाली मीडिया वो भी सुन ले अपने डेस्क पर बैठ करके टट्टू लोगों को लड़ाते रहते हैं वो भी सुन ले कुरान इस्लाम रसूल की जात पर हमले कराने के लिए जरखरीद लोगों को बिठाते वो भी सारे न्यूज एंकर ये पंडित सब जमा हो जाए मैदान में ये फकीर कादरी हाजिर होगा एक बड़ी आग जलाई जाए आग लगाई जाए मैं उससे कहता हूँ मैं भी आग में दाखिल होऊंगा तू भी आग में दाखिल होगा
खलीसी
जो सलामत रहेगा उसका दीन हक पहचाना जाएगा मुसलमानों बहुत हो गया एहतजाज बहुत हो गए प्रोटेस्ट बहुत हो गए इनसे मुतालबे करना कि इसको गिरफ्तार करो इसका सर चाहिए आओ आज आर पार की बात कर
That's what he said. He said, it's enough. And he's crying. It's enough. We ask them to give us their head, but they don't. He's sick of it. He's sick of world not becoming wild animals at their request.
सरकार गरीब नवाज को भी यही चैलेंज किया गया था मोइनुद्दीन हसन चिश्ती ने हिंद में यह बताया था कि जो नबी का गुलाम होगा वो आग में भी कूद जाएगा.
So this genius has made a challenge because he's sick and tired of people not beheading other people at their peaceful requests. So he's come up with a new ingenious way, and apparently he quoted some Chishti guy did that. I don't know whether he did it or not, but he was given the same challenge. So he goes, you know what? He said that any lover of the Prophet will jump in the fire. Kind of like how Khaleesi in Game of Thrones did. You know, she went in, but a very beautiful sight came out of that fire. But in this case, I don't think anything's going to happen. Even if he did survive, his clothes are burnt. We don't want to see what's underneath that. But anyway, he would survive anyway. But so he's challenging this Hindu pundit who has become very radical and abusive towards Islam. I don't care, you know, like the only thing I care about is like, just don't be violent. And I did condemn him when I showed you the video a couple of weeks ago where one of his disciples beat up a 14-year-old kid inside a temple. So I condemned that. But other than that, I don't care what kind of language he uses against Islam or Muhammad. So he's challenging him, you know, let's jump in the fire. You bring your Hindu scriptures, I bring my Quran, and, you know, whoever comes out will be fine. And we all know if anyone jumps in, nobody's going to come out. So anyway, so that guy has actually accepted the challenge. So have a look what he had to say.
बुला रहा है मुझे दिल्ली में अग्नि परीक्षा के लिए. उसने मुझे चुनौती दी है कि मैं हिंदुओं के धर्म ग्रंथ लेकर आऊं, पर वो अपना जो उनका क्या है कोई गुंडों की किताब है ये कुरान.
I love the diss here. What is that book? That book of thugs, the book of the Quran.
नाम की उसे लेकर आएगा, ये लुटेरों की जिहादियों की जो किताब है, और वो कह रहा है आग जलाई जाएगी उसमें से वो भी निकलेगा और मुझे भी निकलना पड़ेगा. मैं इस जंगली जाहिल लुटेरे की चुनौती स्वीकार करता हूं. मैं मौलानाओं को आदमी नहीं मानता.
So he's saying, okay, I accept that. So they're both radicals with their beliefs and they're both going to jump in. But I think, let me add some spice in that. If these two guys come out alive, I will... Oh, hang on. That's a bit of a predicament. Which religion will I have to pick? Islam or Hinduism? Anyway, whoever comes out alive, I will... They can decide my fate. I will either spend the rest of my life preaching their religion, or I will also jump in the fire if that's the punishment they would like me to have. So please, go for it. Jump, 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 jump. I don't think they're going to jump. These guys are not going to jump. But it's not just jump, you just go through it. You know, like we can see that how people can quickly walk over red-hot burning coal. So none of the trick. Just, you know, set up a big fire and no empty space in between, like the full fire, and sit in there like this. You know, read a book or something, you know. Then that's how we'll buy it, but... Yeah, burn, baby, burn. Burn. But that's not going to happen.
To help me produce more videos like these, support me on Patreon or PayPal.